Hello again, and it's time for another project. Nice, easy ones today. We're going to route out and cut out on a scroll saw a couple of these Mr. Men characters. They're quite popular in the UK. If you Google Mr. Men characters, you'll find plenty to go at. I do believe there's 85 of those to do. We're obviously not going to do 85 of them. I've made some previously. They all do have a name. This one here is Mr. Clever. This one's Mr. Sneeze. This one is a Mr. Appy. You can see we've done one. A Mr. Bump. And this one's a Mr. Strong, believe it or not. So today's little project is to cut out two more of those, giving us five in total. As always for me, we've got our template ready. What I've been doing on these small, simple projects is to basically Google the image you're after. So we would put in Mr. Sneeze, and you can see it there on the tablet. And basically all I would do is get the tracing paper. I'm using tracing paper for now. It's ideal for those that haven't got any kind of printer or printing paper. And I know that this wood is 5.5 inches wide. Sorry, the screen is 5.5 inches wide. The same as the pieces of wood, basically this fancy wood that I like to use, and it just gives me 1/4 inch at either side to play with. All I do is simply get your image. You can make it bigger or smaller. I go to the maximum, like I said, which is like 5 inches, if that. And you can put your tracing paper on, and it is possible to trace around that. It's a bit awkward, as long as you keep your hand away from the screen. I tend to put my pieces of paper long ways and a bit of tape at either side, and it is possible to draw around that just to give you enough to get that template what we've got there. As you can see, I did that on all the other ones as well. Then obviously then you put that on, stick that on top of your carbon paper and draw around it again, and you can see from that we've got our Mr. Sneeze, just about see him there, and Mr. Clever on that side. Now the idea, like I've just said, is to route these out. They're ideal because you basically just route out all the body, as we can see from there. Shading the areas we want to remove, so inside the hats, circles around the eyes, all the body. And on Mr. Sneeze, inside the mouth, all the body, and inside the eyes, leaving the black centres. We'll route this down to about 3 millimetres, which is obviously the thickness as a Dremel bit, or one of these CNC bits. So because we are cutting out the surrounding, this is all scrap wood, we'll route out a couple of depths on there just so that fits in to the depth that we want. So I'm working on 3 millimeters for now. Works fine for most of my projects. They are actually 3.175, but we'll call them 3 millimeters today. And once we've routed out these two little characters, we'll simply get a spiral blade on a scroll saw, and we'll go around and cut them both out. And then we're going to give them a general tidy up, and then we'll get onto the painting side. So actually, when we're done, we'll have little characters like this. Okay, we'll set the router up in our router, and then we'll start routing these ones out. Just before we do, I'll just mention the CNC bit we're going to use. This is a 20 degree today. They do come in 10s, 15s, 20s, 30s, and I believe there's a couple of 60s out there as well. They do have a Dremel size shaft on them, a 3.175 millimeter, so that will fit a Dremel no problem if you only have a Dremel with a router attachment. If you're going to use a 1/4 inch shafted router, you need an adapter reducer collet, like so, 6.35 millimeter. Then you literally just slot that into there, into the silver end, pop that darker end into your router, and that work in the router no problem whatsoever. What we use that for is to go around all the lines. Remember, we're doing inset, so we'll run a route inside that line. If we're doing outset, which is the surrounding area, we'll route to that side of the line. Never route on the line, because by the time you've gone something like this, if you'd route round the eye on the inside and the outside, that distance in between would be a lot thinner. So you always route up to the line, and always route up to the line on that side. Once we've done both pieces on all the areas that we need to go around with the CNC bit, I'll pop on one of these end milling bits. We'll get away with something quite big. So a big one like that, that literally fits the same adapter collet. So it's just a case of removing the CNC bit. Pop that one in, up to that nice little barrier. We'll set it to the same depth, which is going to be 3 millimeters, remember. And we'll just start removing all the backer. There is bigger bits out there. I've got plenty myself. But to get inside here and inside the eyes, you'll be swapping and changing. I'll just take it. It takes 5 minutes. And you can soon remove all that body with one of those end milling bits. Okay, let's set out our 20 degree CNC bit in the router. Do a couple of samples on the side, just get our depths nice. There is depth gauges out there you can buy. Fancy digital things that you literally just put under your router. And you can set it to the same depth every time. Personally, every project can vary depth-wise. So it's a personal thing how deep or how shallow you want to go. Okay, let's start routing these little Mr. Men characters out. Okay, you can see from that we've gone all the way around with our CNC bits. These are little gauges that we tried out just to make sure we've got a nice depth. So they're roughly about 3 millimeters. And that's a nice depth to work at. So we've gone around all our lines. We've moved some of the smaller bits in between, as you can see from that. I do apologise for the video in today. It looks very white when I'm filming and its focus is just terrible. So I nearly scrapped this video at one time, but we'll go with it. I'm sure you can appreciate I only have basic materials regards to phone and lighting and what have you. So what you see is basically what you get. Anyway, we'll continue. So we're going to start removing all the inner sections now. Remember, that's all the penciled out area that we want to remove now. You can see I've done the eyes on both these characters already, so they're no problem. And the same on that one above. Now I like to use these end milling bits. There is bigger bits out there and there's fantastic bits out there at fantastic prices. These are another cheap option. These are metric straight bits. I mean, you get massive chunky things like that. Obviously, you won't even fit that inside the legs. So obviously you bear that in mind. We'll struggle with that one in there. You'll definitely get that one in there, no problem whatsoever. But we won't get it inside there. So it's just a personal preference what bit you would like to use as regards to removal. I'll just stick with these little end milling bits. They work fantastic. I've got no issues with them. They clean out pretty good. If you just take your time and enjoy what you're doing. So it's just a simple case of removing the CNC bit. We'll put that to one side so we'll get a lot more projects out of that one. And you'll slot that in there like so. Onto that little barrier. That's a new thing, is that barrier. When I first purchased these, I did actually try to remove all those, but they're glued on there solid. And the idea is that you push it up inside your adapter collet like that. We'll slot that in. We can set it to one of these depths up here. Or to that one there, remember. And we'll start removing the inners. Let's do that next.
Right, we've made it all the way round with our end milling bits. Remember, there is better bits out there. It's just a personal preference. Just a case of finding the one that you're happy to use. And they work fine for me. Remember, this is just cheap fencing wood. So we're going to have to do a general tidy up. As always for me, I like to use a flexi cable. This is attached to an end of a Dremel with an engraving bit of some description inside. I like to use one which's got a flat bottomed head on it. Literally, we can go around and just give it a general tidy up like so. Just get rid of the fluffy bits that you will see on the end of there. Now, engraving bits, they come in different sizes and shapes and forms. You get a good packet of 30 for next to nothing like so. And just finding one that you're comfortable with. This is a smaller pointed one. That might be ideal when we come to clear inside the eyes of that one. Okay, we've got that, and we'll do a general tidy up, and then we'll get on to the cutting it out on a scroll saw. Right, we've gone round with our engraving bits, just to give it a general tidy up. I will be doing a little bit more sanding on this once we've actually cut it out, just to round those edges off and give it a little bit more shape. But you can basically see what's going on with Mr. Sneezer's mouth and Mr. Clever at this end. So now the next stage is just basically just cut them out quickly with a scroll saw, nothing too fantastic. For those that's new to the scroll saw, there's three types of blade. There is fancier blades out there with fancier names, but they all basically do the same thing. These are your three standard ones, as I would call them. You get what they call a pin blade. That has a pin at both ends like so. They're for your more cheaper and basic saws, if that makes sense. When you put the scroll saw blade in your saw, you want it facing towards you. You want it to feel smooth on the way down and rough and jagged like that on the way up. That way you know you've got your blade in the right way. Now you could use a pin blade on this one, no problem, because it's such an easy cut. We just pop it in there and start cutting around, no worries. If we're doing inset lettering, cut out should I say, you imagine going inside the eyes here. If we had to cut out the centre of those eyes, you just wouldn't fit in with a pin blade. You would obviously drill yourself a pilot hole, and then you would have to feed the blade through if we're going to remove that section. And that's why they come out with pinless blades. These are what the majority of scroll saw users use. On your fancier saws, you'll have a clamp at top and a clamp at the bottom. Same again, teeth towards you, facing down, smooth on the way down, rough way on the way up. These are fantastic if you're getting tight areas like so, where you could slot that in there easy and cut out the centre of the eye if we were doing that. Third blade for me, I like to use a spiral blade. The teeth are actually spiral the full length of the blade. Same with these ones. They want to feel smooth on the way down and rough on the way up. I have to use these adapter clamps on my old draper saw. They're a bit of a pain to use sometimes, but once you get used to them, they're fine and they'd serve a purpose. The good thing about a spiral blade, because it does cut in any direction, we could literally just start there and feed the wood like so, without turning the wood once. They're not for everybody. They do take a little getting used to. But once you master them, I won't use anything else now. Whereas if we use a pin blade or a pinless blade, we would have to start there. We'd have to cut that in like so, and then turn that wood for it to come towards you, and then turn it again to go down there, and turn it again, and turn it. And there's a lot of turning and twisting. There's some fantastic people out there that do phenomenal work. Unfortunately, I'm not one of them, so I'll just stick to my little scroll saw blade, cut it out with that. Okay, we'll pop that on the scroll saw and we'll cut these two out. We'll be right back. Right, we've got all the way round with our scroll saw blade. Spiral one for me, just personal preference. Pegas number 5 I like to use. And they cut really nice. I've certainly got no issues with them. Now, once a general tidy up to get these little fluffy bits on the back there, remove them off. Bit of sandpaper. Like so. It takes seconds, if not minutes, to do. And then we'll go around with the paper like so. I just want to round these off slightly so they're not so sharp. And we'll also skim over it all with a mouse sander just to tidy it up a little bit more. Right, that's enough cleaning down and tidying up for me. We will be skimming over this just one more time, literally just because we're going to paint the inside of this, so we can really put the paint on quite freely. Doesn't matter if we get it on the face, on the mouth or the glasses or anything, because we're going to skim over it again with a mouse sander on both pieces, just to make them sides a little bit more crispier. And then we're going to paint all the surround black and all the side bits as well. Now, for hanging purposes, like on my previous projects, I'll just put a T-slot bit and route out a slit in the back. And I want to show you on one of these, just to show you how it's done. But literally, it's one of these. It's a quarter-inch shaft, so you don't need the adapter collet in your router. So it's got a full chunky side on it there. And this is a 5/16. 5/16 this one. This is the smallest one I could find at the time. And it's ideal for my size of screws that I use for hanging up with. And the idea is that you basically just route out a slit in the back, T-slot bit, remember this one, like so. I did a couple of samples on a scrap piece of wood and I set it to the same depth on every one because I noticed there's enough wood in there for that screw to go behind. If I just find it again for you. So you basically slot your screw on there and slide that across, and that's enough to hold your project in place. Now, the further you have that into your wood, so at least you just have the head of the screw showing, that can get really tight to push that on, and you've got less chance of it moving about. If it's too tight, you can literally just screw it out of the wall slightly, and it'll be a lot looser. So I'm going to do one just to show you, and then we can move on to the painting side of things. Right, so we've got the T-slot bit in the router, as you can see. Like I said previously, this is my sample one, and this is a depth that I'm happy with it. You don't want to go too deep, obviously, because you've got to remember you've routed out areas here, so you do have that thickness to play with. So that's the one I use all the time, same depth, and I've marked it off with a little bit of pencil. Then I know if I just set my router into that, like so, lower it in all the way down, we'll lock it off. I know that's going to slide across like that. And that depth is nicely set now, but it's not going to go through the other side of the piece. And that's enough wood there to hold that in place. Okay, we'll route one out quickly just for you to see. Okay, that's our slit done. Now, it doesn't matter if it's not perfectly straight. It's only going at the back of the piece, remember. And that's enough now for us to get our screw in there. Slide that across. That'll be on there really tight. And that's going to be enough to hold that project. That's not going to go anywhere. Okay, so that's your T-slot bits for hanging purposes.
Right, we've done our two slits in the back. So we'll have no problem hanging these. Now, painting wise, just cheap acrylic paint for the centres. I add a bit of water just so it makes more of a stain than actual paint itself. And you might have to go over them a couple of times. White's always an awkward colour, so is the yellow. And for the surrounds, painter's touch black. We'll do all the surrounding area around the mouth, the smiley face, and the sides as well. So I'll go away and paint this. and then come back after we've put on a bit of crystal clear spray just to give it a nice shine. Right, that's it. This little project is over. Now I gave them both 3 or 4 coats of our crystal clear just to give them a nice shine and a little bit more protection with them going outside. You can see from that we've got a nice shine on. I've also painted the backs of these for some reason. Just got a bit carried away with the paint, but it certainly won't do it any harm. So these are just nice, easy little projects that basically anybody can do. There's not a lot of skill required. They're just fun little projects. Don't think that you've got to go out and do your 15-foot by 6-foot projects to be something worthwhile. The little ones count just as much as the big ones. So there we have it. This little project is over. So they're routed out on fencing wood using a CNC bit, cleared out with end mill bits, and then we use a Pegas number 5 spiral blade, literally just to cut them out. So they're your Mr. Men characters. Like I say, there is 85 of them. I certainly won't be doing any more. So we have a Mr. Sneeze, a Mr. Clever, we have a Mr. Happy, a Mr. Strong, and then to end it all, Mr. Bump. And that's it. Thank you very much for watching.